Dear friends, good morning. Today I will be discussing with you a topic which is very famously known as Joule Kelvin effect. Now let us discuss the experiment which Joule and Thomson did long time back. What they did, they took a huge pipe which is literally insulated so that no heat can escape from it, and they introduced a plug or a valve. The purpose of introduction of this valve is to regulate the exit pressure. Now consider this as my inlet and this as my exit. At the inlet, let the pressure be PI, temperature be TI, and at the exit, the pressure be PE and temperature TI. Now in this case, there is no work interaction. Work interaction is zero. At the same time, as this is adiabatically sealed, heat interaction will also be zero. So, if we write energy equation, we can simply say energy entering is equal to energy exiting. That is, m dot I h I plus v I square by 2 plus 3 z I will be equal to m dot I h I plus v I square by 2 plus 3 z I. Now, if you neglect the changes in kinetic and potential energies, then you can simply write m dot I h I is equal to m dot I h I. And as this is steady, so I can write h I is equal to h I because m dot I will be equal to m dot I for steady state case. Now, this is the important point in this. This is basically what we are throttling the gas or the substance which is flowing through it. We are throttling means we are adjusting the, we are changing the downstream pressure, and this can be done with the help of a valve or a porous plug or any obstruction placed in the path of flow. Now, this is known as throttling. What is throttling? Throttling is a process in which no heat is transferred to or from the control volume. At the same time, no work is done to or from the control volume. And in this case, the enthalpy remains the constant and the pressure reduces. So, the inlet pressure will always be more than exit pressure, that is reduction in pressure. But the point is, what about the exit temperature? We do not know what exactly the exit temperature will be. Means whether this throttling will make this exit temperature lower than the inlet temperature, or whether it will remain constant, or whether it will increase the temperature. Now you see there are two opposing effects working here. The first one, as this throttling is an irreversible process because friction is coming into play. So because of this friction, pressure is getting reduced. So because of friction, the temperature will try to increase because of this dissipation. But because of expansion of gas, what will happen? The temperature will try to reduce. So these are two opposing effects which are working. So because of which there may be temperature increase, there may be temperature decrease, or the temperature remains constant. It solely depends on which effect is more pronounced, whether this or this. So what they did, they kept this, they kept the pressure constant and then varied this and plotted them. It is, let us say this is temperature and this is exit pressure, and they kept the initial pressure same constant and then varied the exit pressure like this. So they got one curve like this. I am making this dotted because because throttling throttling is irreversible. They got this curve, and this is a constant enthalpy curve. That is an isenthalpy. As in case of throttling, enthalpy remains constant. We have just seen. So if this is for a certain pressure and temperature limits upstream, or this is for certain value of, this is for certain value of inlet enthalpy. Now, if we vary the inlet enthalpy, if we change the inlet enthalpy, or if we change the pressure, we will get another curve. Like this, so many curves. And this is the point where the slope of this curve is becoming zero. And this point where the slope of this curve is becoming zero, that is the isenthalpy becoming zero, is known as inversion point. That is the point where the slope of this curve, that is isenthalpy, is zero. Now I'll draw it once more for better clarity. So this is temperature, this is exit pressure. So these all are isenthalpy at different inlet pressure or different enthalpies. So if I join all the inversion points here, what I'll get? I'll get a curve which is joined by all the inversion points. And this curve is called as inversion curve. Now you look. On the left side of this inversion curve, the slope of these isenthalpies is positive. That is, on the left side, what is this? This slope is more than zero. And on the right side, this slope is less than zero, that is negative. So if we are on the right side of the slope and we are doing throttling, that is, we are reducing the pressure, what is happening to temperature? It is increasing. So that's why this region is called as heating region. It means if we throttle a gas in this region, then throttling will lead to increase in its temperature. And this region is called as cooling region. Why? Because if we throttle a gas in this region that is moving to a lower pressure, then what is happening to temperature? It is reducing. That's why it is called as cooling region. That is, if we throttle a gas in this region, the gas will always cool. So if the sole purpose of throttling is to reduce the temperature of any gas, then what you should do is you should keep the gas initial temperature at the inversion point and then reduce its pressure, and that reduction in pressure will lead to a lower value of temperature. And if you are in this region, that is in heating region, let us draw this curve again. Let us draw this curve again. Now this is my inversion curve. and this is that isenthalpy I'm talking of. Now, if I am in this heating region and I do throttling of it, what will happen? The pressure will reduce. But the question is whether the temperature is reduced or not. So this will be answered like this. If I am doing throttling, I am moving around this, and I am moving in such a way that the final pressure becomes lower than this value. If this is initial pressure, this is final pressure. If become less than this, then there will be a reduction in temperature. And if the final pressure is below this, is above this, then there will never be a reduction in temperature. So you see, if we are in this region, that is cooling region, then throttling will always lead to a reduction in temperature. But if we are in heating region, then the throttling can reduce the temperature if the pressure is below this value, or it can increase the temperature, or if the pressure is this, so the temperature will not change, will not get changed. So this is the importance of this inversion. Now this point is called as maximum inversion temperature, and this is minimum inversion temperature. So if you want to cool any gas, then the temperature of that particular gas should always be, the temperature of ambience at which the gas is right now should always be lower than its maximum inversion temperature. Then only that gas can be cooled by throttling, otherwise no. So let us consider a case where these are the different isenthalpies, where the gas is at a temperature which is more than inversion temperature. Let us say this temperature. Now you do throttling now, it means you reduce the pressure. So what will happen? You move in this direction. But you see, as you are throttling this gas, so you are moving towards a higher temperature. Hence, whenever you throttle a gas, you should make it, this thing should be kept in mind, that the temperature of gas should always be less than the maximum inversion temperature for that particular gas. Then only you can reduce the temperature of gas, otherwise it will increase. Now for hydrogen, there is a very special case. Hydrogen, this maximum inversion temperature is 400 Kelvin, and ambient temperature normally is 300 Kelvin, that is 27 degrees Celsius. So if you want to cool the hydrogen gas, which is at 300 Kelvin, that is at ambient temperature, then this is not possible with the help of simple, then there is not possible with the help of simple throttling. Because in that particular case, what will happen? Let us say that this is my 300 mark and this is 200 mark, then the temperature will always increase, it will never reduce. And that's why it is said that whenever hydrogen is leaking from the cylinder, then always there will be an increase in temperature or the chances of explosion. So what to be done in case of hydrogen? It is first cooled with the help of liquid nitrogen. And then it is cooled with the help of liquid nitrogen to a temperature which is below 200 Kelvin, let us say 100 Kelvin. And then this is throttled to reduce its temperature. Now there is one more thing. This slope, that is del T upon del P, this is represented by J. This is called as Joule Kelvin coefficient. Now this Joule Kelvin coefficient is this. So there is a mathematical expression existing for this, and which comes from here. We know that dH is equal to TdS minus VdP. At the same time, we have a TdS relation which says TdS Cp dT minus Cp dT minus V del V upon del T at constant pressure dP. Now this is plus, sorry. So what is this dH? This dH will be Cp dt plus V minus, this is T, V minus T del V by del T at constant pressure dP. Now you divide this equation by T. You will get this. So, if you keep the temperature as constant, that is, sorry, if you keep the enthalpy as constant, then what will happen? Cp is will become equal to T del V by del T at constant pressure minus V del P by del T at constant enthalpy, or del T by del P at constant enthalpy is equal to 1 by Cp T del V by del T at constant pressure minus V. So this is the Joule Kelvin coefficient. And for an ideal gas, for an ideal gas which obeys PV is equal to RT, so del V upon del T at constant pressure for this gas will simply be R upon P. So replacing this value here, you will get del T by del P at constant enthalpy is equal to 1 upon Cp T R upon P minus V. What is RT? It is PV. So 1 upon CV, PV upon 2 minus V. So we will get 0. That means for an ideal gas, Joule Kelvin coefficient is always 0. So if you look your inversion curve, this is the curve where this Joule Kelvin coefficient value is 0. Hence, ideal gas always follow this Joule Kelvin. This ideal gas will always follow this inversion curve. So, for an ideal gas, if you throttle it, there is no change in temperature. So, this is all about Joule Kelvin coefficient, inversion curve, throttling, and so the last thing which I want to tell you is just remember one thing. With respect to Joule Kelvin coefficient, that for all gases at ordinary temperature and pressure, this mu J value is always more than 1. For all gases at ordinary temperature and pressure, mu J is always more than 1, and the maximum temperature, maximum inversion temperature for all the gases is above room temperature. Except what? Except hydrogen, helium, and neon. So, a knowledge of inversion curve for real gas is of considerable importance in the design of refrigerators and liquefaction equipment. So this all I have to say with respect to this. Thank you so much for your kind hearing. If you like my video, then please do subscribe.